Thank you, sir. A very good afternoon to all of you. I'm going to speak on history and current status of wood culture in India. Now, basically, this topic is very, very vast. And Indian wood culture has been so rich that my talk might appear as if I'm trying to show lamp to the sun. Okay, so I'm just making a small attempt on trying to speak on wood culture in India. Basically, in India, Forest Research Institute, Dehradun, is the premier institute that has been carrying out research in almost all disciplines of wood science since past 100 years. And we have been rendering yeoman service to the entire nation through inputs on identification, properties, uses, seasoning, and preservation of timbers. And our regular clients include a long list. I'll skip this list because I have to confine to 15 minutes time that has been given to me. And basically, it is because of our association with Archaeological Survey of India that we come to know about the wood culture of India. Right, so we have been doing a lot of work for ASI, Archaeological Survey of India. So we came to know about the woods which were found during the excavations done by this organization. We all know that ancient civilization of the old world, basically we had three oldest ones, Egyptian, the Mesopotamian, and this Indian Valley civilization, Indus Valley civilization. And this basically dates between 3500 to 1000 BC. So this is, I'm trying to speak upon the oldest civilization of the world. So ancient civilization of erstwhile India is about 5000 years old. And the written information that we have on wood is about 3500 years old. And most of our information of the written records come from Ved, Upanishad, Purans, and two main religious texts, that's Ramayana and Mahabharata. And this explorations in India started in 1784 by Asiatic Society. And this was later on increased by Archaeological Survey of India when it was formed in 1861. Now, I'm just mentioning few lines which have been found in our old text. First is that our old text talks about existence of a class of artisans which were known as Vadhaki or the carpenters. There is instructions on choice and handling of wood for boat and shipbuilding. There is also a mention about strong and durable timbers for making thrones of kings. We have some mention about seasoning properties of different timbers. And then some woods have been mentioned which are supposed to be used for making sculptures of the deities. Like it was mentioned in some of the texts that the Scalatropis should be used for making Ganesha, while Black Ebony should be used for making Krishna. Now this god of India is a fair god, while Krishna is a dark colored guy. So likewise the wood has been chosen. Now coming to the first period, that's a prehistoric period where we don't have much of the written records. And talking about 2500 BC to 100 AD, lot of excavations were done in India of this period, and we have reports from all these places. We got wood samples from these places which were identified at FRI, and based on that we have drawn some cultural aspects of wood uses. So I'll be taking up these sites one by one and we'll try to build the whole thing, right? So talking about the first area, that's in Kashmir, and we found twigs of Parousia, Prunus, and Juniper. Interesting part is that this Prunus twigs for wicker work are still used in this particular area. So this reflects upon the immortal traditions that we have in our country. Then talking about Indus Valley civilization, I'll touch upon few of the areas of this civilization. And coming to the next site, that's the Harappa, which is Bronze Age site. And this dates between 2500 to 2000 BC. The wood remains of a coffin was identified by us to be made up of Cedrus Devdara and Delbergia latifolia, that's rosewood. So basically this particular study reflects that Harappans were well acquainted with the use of durable and scented woods. They knew where these woods are available, And then they had trade connection because this particular wood, Devdar, comes from high Himalayan ranges and rosewood comes from central India. Then another wood that was found in that area was gingivorous. Now this particular wood has been now scientifically proved to be having highest shock absorbing property. But this wood was used by Harappans in 2000 BC for making mortars for pounding rice. So this particular thing reflects upon the knowledge of wood properties that prevailed during those times. Coming to another site as Lothal, it's a port town. Here one can see. And this is the first tight dock of the world constructed for berthing and servicing of ships. So boat building technology in India dates back to 3rd millennium BC. And the woods which were found in this area, I just listed them down. I'll just talk about this Acacia chindra. Now this particular wood is supposed to be the best wood for marine purposes, and it is also said to be a substitute of the world-renowned wood Guaicum officinal, which comes from South America. I'm just skipping some of my slides. Then few finds were found in the of this Chalcolithic site dating between 1700 BC to 800 BC, and woods that were found were Sisu and Holoraina, Acacia and Chloroxylon, and these woods are known for their calorific value. So this shows that people of those times were using these woods for fuel purposes, which again reflects that knowledge of calorific value of wood existed during this period. Then another site is Karla Caves. Here we found a sample of 2,200 years old of teak. And another site, we found a sample of sal, which was 2,250 years old, right? So basically, apparently they appear to be quite in a good sound condition, and only 60% of it has turned into amorphous one. That means 40% was still crystalline. So that shows that people of those times were having very good knowledge of wood durability also. I'm skipping another one. I'm so sorry, I was given 20 minutes time earlier, so I have to squeeze my things. Now, this is another very interesting study that was carried out. This is a place near our near Dehradun only, and we found a Havan Kund in which there were charred remains. These charred remains were identified to be sal, terminalia, mango, and cinnamomum. Interestingly, we still use mango and cinnamomum. Cinnamomum is kapoor, right? So it is still used for yagna purpose, which reflects the timeless and immutable Indian customs. Then wood culture after 5th century AD can be seen in our temples, palaces, artifacts, as well as in written record, which still exists today. I've just shown some examples of the temples that are there, which still exist and are in very good condition also. Here you can see this is temple of Chamba. This is Mripila Devi temple of Lahore. This is Hidamba Devi temple. You can see beautiful carvings on wood. And in northern India, most of the time the wood used was Sidrus Devdara, that's Devdar, right? While in the towards the south, the woods were quite different. And this is another very famous temple of South India, and built in between 16th to 18th century AD. And it, we can find teak beams, carvings of rosewood, then Sweetenia, and Artocarpus heterophilus columns can be seen in this temple. Then another example, the same thing. We have palaces having all wooden built up, almost of the entirely built up of wood. Here again, this is in Bangalore itself. Then we have sculptures made of wood, and a few examples I brought here. This these sculptures dates between 14th to 16th century AD, and most of them were made up of Madhuka. Now this species today has been scientifically proved to be very, very strong and a durable timber, even in contact with soil and water. So Use of this timber reflects on the very good knowledge that existed during the 14th to 16th century AD. Similarly, the same thing. These are few another examples, the sculptures, the houseboats that are there in Kashmir, and then some of the exhibits which are made up of very, very durable woods. Then Indian music, of course, has an accumulated heritage of centuries. The origin can be traced back to Vedic days, that is about 2500 BC. And the woods which are basically used for making these instruments are all these listed ones, the teak, shisham, toon, rosewood, artocarpus, walnut, diosperus abernethy, and bamboos. So this shows that people were aware of the mystical joy of wood right from the very beginning. Then this 19th century can be said to be the era of modern wood science, and we have a FRI Xylarium being established in 1878. We have this first book written on timber trees by Dr. Balfour in 1858, and then came the most important publication, which is A Manual of Indian Timbers, written by Gamble. Now, this particular book deals with the physical features, properties, and uses of 1450 Indian woods. The most interesting part of this publication is that knowledge of uses came from locals. Okay, because by that time, no scientific study was carried out. So today it has been proved that whatever was written in that book is still holds true from scientific angle also. So this shows an excellent scientific wisdom on wood uses by our people. And then of course, we Indians have always been obsessed by wood. Forest Research Institute, it celebrated its centenary in 2006. And this is the one of the Asia's biggest wooden hall at FRI, which is made up of Tectuna grandis, that's teak. The roof is made up of Pinus roxburghii. The floor is made up of Pterocarpus macrocarpus. And then coming to the current status. In India, we have some 1600 tree species, out of which 276 has been classified as commercial timbers. 99 are classified as rare and threatened. 4 have been cited under sites, which are Pterocarpus centellinus, Taxus wallichiana, Aquilaria melacensis, and Araucaria. This is exotic but has been grown in India. And then about 85 are medicinally exploited woods. Ours is a mega diverse country with 16 different forest types and tremendous wood diversity. We have all colors varying from light buff to jet black color woods. We have lightest to heaviest wood with us. We have the most sweet smelling wood to most foul smelling wood. We have beautifully figured woods, and also we have very, very naturally durable woods. We have Indian standards being formulated for the scientific utilization of the wood. For each purpose, there are woods which are being classified, and based on that, various departments are supposed to use those woods only. So we have Indian standards for doors, windows, cooling towers, for wooden sleepers, for aircraft, and all other purposes. And this is regarding the scientific utilization of the wood. Then, of course, talking about bamboo was used from time immemorial in India, and it is referred as the cradle to coffin timber. We have 140 species, 19 genera of it, and it covers 13% of our forest area. So a lot of work has been done on this. We have, again, various Indian standards formulated, and bamboo is being used for structural purpose these days. Mat boards, veneer composite, corrugated sheet, etc. are being made out of it. Then talking about present wood culture scenario in India, the scenario is the demand of wood is much, much more than the supply. Our main concerns are illicit felling and trade, the pest traded along with the imported timbers. The quality of timber varies from very poor to good quality timbers. Then there is inappropriate substitution of wood with high energy materials like aluminium and steel, and or eco-damaging like plastics. Talking about the rationality, the scientific utilization of wood is there, and there's a shift from solid wood to wood substitute. And a lot of government intervention is there regarding forest and industrial policies. I'll give just a brief of these policies. Talking about this sustainability challenges, we still need to go for forest certification. The timber management policies are to be formulated and implemented. The wood alternatives are to be worked out. Then timber in structure and construction engineering, we are not doing much in that, so we need to do more. And education and awareness, of course, has to be brought up more in our country. Coming to the government interventions for sustainable forestry, in India, scientific management of forest dates back to 1864. And today we have complete ban on felling of trees from natural forests since 1996. There is ban on users of wood in construction works of CPWD. Basically, Central Public Works Department is the main construction organization of India. Then National Working Group is constituted to frame guidelines on forest certification for timber and non-timber forest products. Then launching of Green India Mission. It is one of the 8 missions of Indian National Action Plan. And it targets 20 million hectares to be afforested by 2020. Then there is subsidy on plantation of sandalwood, and grower is the owner policy has been adopted. Then government policies for enhancing timber imports. These are some of the policies that were framed. And then lastly, considering the social awareness and government policies in the right direction, the future of wood culture in India seems to be sustainable. And I conclude by using the same phrase of IWCS, using wood is good, using locally grown wood is better. Thank you.